Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Srishav from the team of IIT Bombay X, which is mentored by Aparna ma'am. So what IIT Bombay X is, it is a leading platform in India, but yet it is not that much of in use. So the basic reasons behind this is, students are not able to find it comfortable to use it, and teachers also find it a hectic process to enroll their courses online. All the projects here are aim is to maintain and simplify the all the work process. Starting from the first project, that is OpenEdX server task automator using XBlock. In this, we will provide a XBlock which allows the admin to perform all the frequently performed tasks over the lifecycle of an OpenEdX server. Moving to the next project, which will be after the admin's work, teacher will be upload his course online. So for that, our next group will be talking about a grid-based component which can be easily integrated with the OpenEdX server. After this, our third project is proctoring as a layer in the XBlock framework, which will check the cheating instances of the student during the examination period. After all of these things, the student should be graded. And this is all about our fourth project will do, that is, it will auto-grade the student's assignment. Then the fifth project is, it will provide API for all the actors involved in this project, like registration of users, course dashboard, and organization dashboard to for OpenEdX platform. So starting with our first project, which is presented by Amol.
Yeah, so coming on to my project is OpenEdX server task automator using XBlock. It's an individual project I have done. Talking about myself, I'm Amol from VIT University, Vellore. So the objective of my project is to create an XBlock. Before telling about objective, I think I should tell about XBlock, people who are not familiar with it. So in the OpenEdX platform on which IIT Bombay X is built, XBlock is basically a single component which can be integrated, and we can change it or use it in whatever way we want. It's like individual component and you can do whatever you want in it. It will perform all the tasks that system administrator frequently performs in the lifecycle of OpenEdX server. In course of doing this project, I found like most of the tasks, it is there in the front end GUI, but few of them currently, it's done by system administrator only through backend using the Linux commands. So my project is an attempt to make them automatic, giving them a very good interactive front end. So what are the tasks that I'm going to cover in my project? My project will firstly include a feature called importing a course. Now, what is importing a course? Faculty will create a course. Currently, OpenEdX platform, it includes a feature only to import and export from a tar file. It doesn't include feature to import and export from GitHub. So my project includes a feature of importing a course from GitHub. I just need to give the Git URL and it will import the course in the backend and it will install it as a new course. Second, activating and deactivating user. About this feature, before this I would like to tell about my meet with the end user of my system. So unlike other projects, my project's end user is only going to be one person who is admin. No one else is going to use this project. So I had a meet with the admin, Mr. Abhilash, here at CC. So I showed him my project and he gave me a few inputs. So one of the input related to activating and deactivating a user was that normally in production server, it is not the admin who will activate. Like when a user registers, he'll be getting an email link. He need to click on that one-time verification email link and the user will get activated. But still it's a pretty handy feature to have because at times when user is not activated, system admin needs to activate him. And also when in the test server, there is no email verification link. So when a lot of users are working, like my entire team was working, we had to create new users. So at that point of time, this feature can really be handy to activate and deactivate a user from front end. Then generating certificate. This feature is still not there in front end. It is only done by admin in the back end using set of Unix commands. So generating a certificate can be done in two ways. It can either be done for a particular user enrolled in a single course, or it can be done for all the users at once who are in a course. Then, just like importing a course, I have a feature for called exporting a course to GitHub also. And then running the asset collections command. This is nothing but compiling all the individual files that server has. And it is sort of like refreshing the server. It takes a lot of time. So this also can be done using this XBlock. And finally, deleting a course. This feature is not there as of now in the front end. To delete a course, it can only be done by admin by executing set of Unix commands in the back end through terminal. So that feature also I have done it. So basically, my project is in and around automating the works flexibly.
No, you are not automating anything.
No, I'm not automating, but I'm normally admin. He has to type like 3-4 commands in terminal to accomplish it. Yeah, I'm typing it for
you. At a click of a button.
At the click of a button. So now I would like to show you the demonstration of how it works. For my project, the most important thing is that because it is system administrator task, it should only be performed by admin. If some normal person like a student or a staff performs it, it's of great threat. So how am I giving that security to my project is? Those who are familiar with the OpenEdX platform must be knowing that you have three types of users in OpenEdX. One is student, second is staff, and the third is admin. So student is nothing but he can just enroll into a course, can attend all the assessments given by faculty, learn things, and give assessments, he will be getting the certificate. Staff is someone who creates the course and keeps on adding assessments and like that. And admin is a person who controls all this, like adding course, deleting course, etc. So my thing can only be accessed by admin. This is the student view. So I will try accessing my Xblog from a student view and let's see if it works or not. It shouldn't work. This is a studio view which from which staff and admins typically work. This is a student view. This is one of my student accounts, so yeah. I have deployed my Xblog in this admin Xblog course.
How the student has access to this block in the first place?
Sir, inside a course only we deploy Xblocks.
Yeah, but that is done by a teacher.
That is done by teacher.
Why are you allowing a teacher to deploy?
No, so normally teacher will not publish it. Just in case teacher by mistake publishes
why
it.
Why are you allowing the teacher to do anything with your Xblock?
Because, no, this is a course, right? It will be there on the in the list of courses. In the studio.
Why the teacher is allowed to publish your Xblock?
Xblock is installed on the server. If by chance teacher gets to know about my Xblock, he can use it.
While installing, it should say no, you don't have any access. Your Xblock is a course.
It's not a course, it's an Xblock, it's a component.
Whatever your component,
yes,
should say whenever somebody is doing something, it cannot be done.
Well, that was not feasible because of the platform. So what I have done is, if a teacher...
No, I don't agree that
it
was not.
No, if teacher installs it also, he cannot use it. That's my concept here.
No, but why is the teacher allowed to install it in the first place?
Because I cannot stop teacher to install it.
Why you cannot stop teacher to install it?
I have installed that Xblock on the server itself. Once it is installed on the server, a teacher can use it in his course. There is no way to stop him from using it. Up to now, Xblock hasn't come into picture.
You sign it?
I have installed Xblock inside a course.
Yeah, but why is the teacher allowed to install this particular Xblock inside the course?
So the thing is that teacher is not installing an Xblock. Xblock is installed on a server.
Correct.
And then if anyone can use that Xblock if it is installed on server. There is nothing like only admin can use. If it is installed on server, it is open to all. Anyone can use it. In that it may
I
be
understand.
Teacher. Yes.
I am not saying you stop the teacher from trying to use that Xblock in
yeah.
his course.
Yes.
So, but the Xblock code gets executed, no?
Yes.
So why don't you throw him out?
Yeah, he's done that.
I have done that to show that only I was showing.
After clicking, I don't even want it there.
Okay, sir. Maybe I'll try doing it. As of now, I don't think it is possible. But
see that. Show me how it works.
Okay. This is the studio view, and now I'm trying to log in from an admin account. So this is the course I have deployed my Xblock in, and this is basically my Xblock.
I don't understand.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
I am deployed in a course.
Yeah, Xblock is a component which should be deployed in a course only.
Okay.
Why you cannot have a separate interface only for admin?
Well, that was not there in my requirements. My requirement was to make an Xblock.
In Dr. Fata's course, Abhilash will put his Xblock to use.
No, he will not. He will create a course for himself.
Perfect. So that course is not visible to anybody, no?
Only for one person.
Basically, you are saying that this Xblock will not be available to anybody. That's all I want.
Yeah, it won't be available to anyone else. That for showing that only, I skipped the
okay.
first two parts.
But how a student can see that Xblock?
No, student
cannot see. Student cannot become part of the course. And even if he becomes part of the course by accident, if he tries to do something like that, he will be thrown out.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Just in case. So I started with the worst case itself. Normally he won't.
Okay,
but if he by chance tries to hack in the system, he can. He will get that screen. That's it.
So your strengths are security and hacking.
Yes. Because it is, I started with that, sir, because it is an admin portal. It should not be accessed by anyone else other than admin. It can cause a great threat. You see, my last option is delete a course. If some normal person deletes a course, then...
Have you checked other security of OpenEdX, IIT BombayX?
Other security? No.
Measures or...
No.
All, everything is safe.
No, I haven't tried much. No, but what project was assigned to me, I had to ensure
continue,
that...
Continue.
Okay, so you got this. He can click on anything and then he says choose option.
Yeah.
Okay, what kind of testing have you done?
I haven't done any...
Any testing?
I went and met him and he tried it himself, system admin.
No,
he told me that he'll bring it into production after me making a few modifications in it. That I will talk in course of showing the features.
He's there for another 1 week.
Yeah.
Okay. And I'll go and tell Abhilash not to listen to him. Okay. Till he produces test data. How anybody will use... A system
no, I have I have tried the in my
producer. You may try everything. Yes. Okay, I'll tell Abhilash what he has tried. He has to document and show everything that has been tried.
I have documented it, sir.
So I to ask you what sort of testing you done. You said I have not done any testing. You documented what?
Like how I have made it and how things are going on inside.
I don't care. Nobody cares. What is the testing you have done?
Like, I normally tried to fail the system in all possible ways. I made test cases for it and then that was how I tested
it. So show me. That's all I am interested in. Show me the test cases.
I have to get my laptop in the Excel.
Okay, so get. Next fellow.
I'll complete this and then I'll show it.
What is this complete? What do you want to do?
I want to show, like, when I import a course, when I activate a user.
No, I don't want to see. Okay. Why should I see? Seriously.
Okay.
It's not a question of time. Why should I see?
So you want me to show the test cases that how...
Exactly. That's all that is required. Nothing else is required.
Okay,
fine.
Let me get my laptop.
Okay, admin will see. Barabar list aata hai ki nahi ye 10 course hai. That's okay. You second fellow continue.